Okay, are we going to be our currently here at our Airbnb that we're staying at here in Lisbon. Just got here not too long ago. This is our living room. Once again, if you all don't know, this is that individual named Christopher Francis, who's very low energy. Hopefully we're going to change that starting today. He's looking at me like he wants to kill me, but that's okay, I'm used to it.
If I had my pastry, I'd be higher.
All right, so moving along to the rest of the place. It's a very nice place, by the way. Here is one of the two bedrooms. This is my bedroom where I'll be staying at. Nice little bed, little setup. And got a little bit of cabinet space and things for that nature. Excuse my desk, I got some of my stuff taken out. All right, after that, next up, go into the bathroom. Just a little small bathroom, but it's cool. It has like a little washing machine and whatnot in it. We also have a shower. Let's see how it looks inside here. Cool, standard shower. Next up, we have the kitchen. This is a very nice kitchen, by the way. Has some nice little colors here, a lot of stainless steel appliances. As you can see, decent little cabinets and material, and sink, etc. And the stove, and there's the microwave. And last of all, the last room of the house, this is Christopher's room. As my room was red, his room is blue. Pretty kind of like the same setup, just slight differences. And he also has some little furniture in here for his little items and food and snacks that he's probably going to sneak in there in the middle of the night. All right, so moving right back along here. One of the things whenever you come to Lisbon or Portugal, everyone always talks about their patel de natas. They are Lisbon's famous pastries. You see Chris is getting a little bit excited like he's about to eat some bacon. Our guest was friendly enough to have some patel de natas waiting for us, so we don't even have to get any. just sitting right here. I know sometimes some people may think they don't look like much, but I hear they're absolutely delicious. So what we're gonna do right now is have a taste test to see. Do you have a particular preference? You want the darker one? Okay. I'll try this one. And we'll do a little review real quick to see how these go. All right, so let's see. It's pretty delicious.
You put to me a pig at the top is burnt, but it's supposed to be burnt. It's almost like cooked, almost like a creme brulee on top.
Out of 5 stars, Chris, what would you give it?
There's always room for improvement. I'd say 3.5 to 4.
I get mine as a...
I mean, it's delicious, 3.8. But I mean...
This is awesome.
I mean, they're like, you know, the you know, flakier.
I could see me eating like 17 of these and then getting sick and throwing up and then eating 15 more. All right, everybody, that's all we have for right now. We're about to head out soon. We have a couple activities for today, and we will keep you posted. Until next time.
cash?
Yeah.
Cash? No. Would you give me something in cash? Something in like proper notes?
Thomas, we will be your crew today. First of all,
nice to meet you.
Let's put the life jackets.
Oh, wait, is this moving?
If you want to lean against the side, so the pontoon is moving.
Yep.
Yes. Haven't lost anyone yet?
Nope.
Oh, what a beat.
So, Lisbon is on that side. This side is not Lisbon anymore. Here we are in the south of Portugal. The attractions here, it goes by, you have in front of you.
Can you hear tomorrow?
Sailing ship.
You can hear it? Yeah.
A beautiful sailing ship is called Dom Fernando de Glória. This ship was doing the route between Lisbon and India. And it was also a warship boat. As this route was really long, it didn't sell. So, if you look to your left side, you will see a really long bridge. It's called Bridge Vasco da Gama. That's around 15 kilometers. Have you been here in this area?
Right here.
This tower is the Tower of Belém. This is the one of the main icons of Lisbon. And it's one of the most visited museums buildings here in Lisbon. It has every year more than 1 million visitors. So this tower was used as a defense tower. If you see, there are windows really close to the water. All of these windows used to have canyons on the inside. So this tower could shoot almost 180 degrees. It was mainly a defense tower, but it was also used as a prison. At the time, it was constructed for a world exhibition that we had here in Lisbon. And 20 years later, they on the inside, there is
take my time.
Portugal hours ago in a speedboat recently. I walking through part of the town. One of the fortunate things you'll notice once you're here is that every 2 seconds somebody's asking you if you want to buy drugs, crack, weed, something else. It's a little bit frustrating. So that's why we're just taking a stroll through the district, and we will be sure to share some other stuff with you a little bit later. Stay tuned.
That's what I kind of feel like.
Street meets Shadyside with the bars per capita of Carson Street with the a little bit more classy ambiance of Shadyside.
Sure.
Yeah.
It's very New Orleans.
Balcony.
I swear, if one more person asks me if I want some fucking drugs.
Wait, what'd you say?
Say, one more person asked us if we want some fucking drugs.
Right, I was having a perfectly lovely conversation about, I can't remember, but this guy in the back seems going, yeah,
that shit was funny as hell, though. Out of all the things he could have tried to sell you.
It should have, but maybe they'll go back.
For a Tuesday, like, I can't wait.
Murder?
Say what?
funny if I fell back right now?
Thank you.